dead tree. You would think people would want to get rid of something like that. But you know what? It's really good for birds. Hi, I'm Nancy Howell with Western Cuyahoga Audubon, and our Audubon group has some fun challenges coming up this fall. On September 11th, 12th, 13th, and 14th, which are a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, we are doing a dead tree birding challenge. Find a dead tree. It could be in your neighborhood, like this one. You can see, this is very urban. You can hear cars going by. You can see the wires going through. So pick a dead tree in your neighborhood, a green space, a cemetery, or a park, but don't go any further than 3 miles from your home. I want to keep it local. And our challenge is to get 50 species, 50 species, from everybody who turns in a list of the birds that they see in dead trees. All right, so why keep a dead tree? Well, I've already noticed house sparrows and a downy woodpecker using this tree. Sometimes they just use it as a lookout. Sometimes they find food in the dead tree. It might be a place for them to perch in the morning to warm up, preen a little bit, dry off. It might be a good vantage point. You know, there might be neighborhood cats moving around, so they want to kind of keep an eye on them. So again, dead trees are really, really important to the environment. Certainly you don't want them in a place where they're going to fall on your house or garage, but they are useful for wildlife. So I hope that you can join us on Friday, Saturday, Sunday, or Monday, September 11, 12, 13, and 14. Watch the same tree. Go out as many times as you would like. But please also remember social distancing, any of the COVID protocols, masks, sanitizing, whatever. If you're in a park, take a picnic. Bring your lawn chair. People come by and ask, what are you doing? Say, I'm watching the dead tree for the species that use that tree. So we hope that you will be able to join us. Remember, we want to get 50 species all together. Thanks so much. Find those dead trees.